Praise the Lord, you are tuning into the media ministry of Apostle Barbara R. Thomas. This ministry is designed to bring forth revelation and encouragement and to enlighten your minds. Now listen as the woman of God brings you revelation from the Word of God.
About what the Lord has promised to do during these 3 days.
Hallelujah.
Because I'm preaching, but because it's a mandated time for the people to be uplifted and uprooted. That's what I heard him say. He said, I'm going to uproot the people from the place that it held them in bondage. Look at somebody and tell them, I'm about to be replanted.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, God.
Hallelujah.
Sometimes with a plant, sometimes you have to replant it.
Yes.
In another pot. Circumstances sometimes causes it to have to be replanted. And I heard the Lord said, because of where he's getting ready to take
you, my.
He's about to replant you. Look at somebody and tell them, I'm about to be replanted.
I'm about to be replanted.
Because where I'm getting ready to go is greater than where I'm at.
Hallelujah.
It's bigger than what I've been through.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands and thank God for the Come on, thank you for the replant. Look at somebody and tell them, I'm about to be replanted.
I'm about to be replanted.
Hallelujah, because the Lord is getting ready to do great things for the women in this house.
Amen.
Out of all that we've been through, ain't it good to know God didn't forget about us? This conference. I thank God for the woman of God. Come on, give God a hand for it. Woman of God.
Amen.
All those that have worked with her on this conference. I got a word, but I got to give a word before I preach the word.
Amen.
Amen.
Because when this word is to you. Because when you were standing over there, the Spirit of the Lord began to deal with me concerning you. And the Holy Ghost told me to tell you that it was worth it all for where he's getting ready to take you. He said it was preordained that you get every hit you got so that you'll be able to help catapult other women into position. And the Lord said, in this day and hour, woman of God, no longer will you be everybody's shadow.
Absolutely not.
The Lord said, this time, it's for you. Because he said, I got to shift her for where I'm getting ready to take her. And I heard him say, tell you every battle was for your making. And even though you had some very strenuous trials that came up against you,
God,
the Lord said, you can give him praise right now. The they can't prostitute your gift.
They sure can't. That's why she with me.
Lift your hands and tell God thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
So you can praise him now because the Lord said the shift has been completed. And he told me to tell you, you have a new place now. So you can praise him.
Thank you, God.
For your elevation.
Hallelujah.
Come on, lift your hands and tell God.
Hallelujah.
I'm determined just to obey God, so
yes, ma'am.
I might not be churchy.
Yes, ma'am. Flow, Father.
I might not be churchy, but I'm going to be in obedience.
Amen.
To what the Lord is saying. I, when she walked in the room, my spirit jumped out at her. And the Lord says she got to know before anything is preached, before anything is said.
Amen.
That she came looking for something that he already don't do.
All right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
She ain't the only one in here. Already shifted.
Oh, my.
Because you're still around the same people that kept you bound. You don't even realize that the Lord don't broke the bondage.
My.
Because you still got the same people trying to go into your new season.
Jesus, come on.
Look at somebody and tell them it's over now.
It's over now.
Look at him and tell him, because I'm being replanted. And I thank God because I know that this has been set aside for such a time as this because the enemy have done everything he can to try to stop this conference. He'll attack in my body that I don't get sick. I don't allow it. And so I knew then that I said, okay, it's some people that's getting ready to go into their next dimension. And so we got to fight the demons that's already at their next dimension before they get there. And so we don't just come just to be coming. You understand what I'm saying? But we're on assignment.
That's right.
And the assignment now is getting ready to be completed these 3 days.
Yes.
Come on, lift your hands and tell God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The Spirit of the Lord dealt with me so heavily about something, and I begin to tell God because, as you know, we're dealing with self. Hallelujah. Yes. And so with us dealing with self, and as women, we have been through a lot of things that we have not really talked about.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
There are some things we can't tell nobody about because then they ain't gonna like us.
Well,
because people look at you and because of what you've been through, they'll misjudge even your attitude. Because they'll look at you one way when God has fashioned you another way.
Amen.
And the Lord began to deal with me about something. And he began to talk to me and he said, a lot of times the women have went through something because of the fact that they have been through traumatic experiences dealing with people. Sometime in our family, sometime in the church, and we have had to deal with people that have put us many times in compromising positions. Look at somebody and tell them
compromising.
Hallelujah. But when a woman has been beaten down and made to feel as if she was not worthy of receiving the good things, her self-esteem can make her
Jesus. Come into agreement with something that she don't want to do, but feel like she got to do.
Right.
So some of even the mistakes we made as women was because of situations and circumstances that we have encountered in life that have caused our self-esteem sometimes to be lower than what it's supposed to be.
Amen.
So I began to deal with something, and the Lord began to talk to me about Leah.
Oh, Lord.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Look at somebody and tell them, everybody don't have a Leah moment.
Leah moment.
My God.
When they were pushed into a situation.
Yes.
Oh my God.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
That they didn't want to do, but felt like they had to do. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Lift your hands and thank God.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So Genesis, the 29th chapter. Hallelujah. We're getting ready to deal with Leah on tonight, because as women, we have to get beyond the competitive stage.
Amen.
Because it's the competition that women are going through.
That's good.
Not just in life, but in the church.
Yes, ma'am. Right. Yes, ma'am.
That have caused us many times to be at odds with each other.
Yes, ma'am.
And to have attitudes toward each other. And to look at each other cross-eyed.
Mm-hmm.
Because we in competition.
Amen.
Oh my God. Hallelujah. Toward each other. Many times we have been placed in that position because people see the potential in both women.
Come on, man. That's good.
Come on now.
And they begin to cause them to fight against each other.
My, my, my. Mm.
So that they can see who can get recognized the most.
Jesus. Jesus. Yep.
My.
So the Lord began to deal with me about
that's
Leah.
Good.
Because we got to understand, and even in this day and hour, that there's a war going on between the older women
and
the younger women.
Yes, ma'am. Absolutely. That's good. That's good. Yes,
there's
ma'am.
A war going on yes, right ma'am. Now because the older women missed out a lot of things.
Yes.
Especially when it came to ministry.
Yes.
Because some of us grew up in an age and an hour when they fought women very adamantly
yes, ma'am.
About working in the kingdom of God. Mm-hmm. We were good enough to raise chicken money.
That's good.
But we wasn't good enough to preach.
See, that's good.
We wasn't good enough to prophesy. Mm-hmm. We wasn't good enough, hallelujah, to do a work in the kingdom of God besides baking, selling,
yes, ma'am,
and serving. Mm-hmm. Uh-oh. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. But the Lord began to deal with me in something concerning Leah, because he begins to let me know, hallelujah, that even though, oh God, her father put her in a predicament.
Yes, he did. Mm-hmm. Yes, he did.
You have to understand at that day and that hour, and because Leah was not as pretty as Rachel.
Right.
You know what I'm about to go right. Sometimes because they think you're not as anointed.
Come on now.
As someone else.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
That you don't have the ability to produce nothing.
Right there.
Oh, come on.
And they'll look over you.
Yes.
Because you have a flaw. But they accept the one that they think is faultless. So God began to tell me, he said, it's about to be a reversal in the kingdom of God.
Yes, ma'am.
Because we getting ready to, oh my God, if I say this, I'm going to get in trouble.
No, you're not. Not over here.
I'm going to get in trouble.
We got you.
Hallelujah. it, because now the Lord is saying the reversal is getting ready to take place, because now we are going to see where the people that look down upon those with flaws are going to understand that those the ones God is using to birth.
Yes, Lord.
We have had too many women fighting against each other. Look at somebody and tell them, you my sister, not my competitor.
Amen.
Lord began to tell me, he said, you got to get the women now to look at each other like sisters.
Come on, absolutely.
And not like competitors.
Yeah.
And the problem with Leah and Rachel was they became competitors and still remaining sisters.
Come on, Jesus.
That's good.
Look at somebody else in heaven. You are my sister.
You are my sister.
What they say about it, you are my sister. I'm not here to fight you. I'm not here to compete with you. I'm not here, oh my God, to go against you, but I'm here to fight you. Look at somebody and tell them, I'm in an embracing moment.
I'm in an embracing moment with you. Yes.
Not trying to destroy you, sister.
Jesus.
That's good.
But I've been put in this position to fight against you.
Jesus.
By somebody that wanted to do somebody else home.
What you say now?
Wow.
Me and Rachel got in a competition that they didn't even start.
Come on,
We didn't start.
Woo. Look at somebody and tell them, I didn't start this.
I didn't start this.
They just pulled me into it.
Yeah.
I wasn't intending to get in this, but they pulled me into it. What you don't understand, my spiritual father got me into this.
That's good.
By making me fight with my spiritual sister.
Jesus, that's good. That's good.
I messed up right here.
No, ma'am.
That's good.
Got some of y'all thinking that. That it wasn't your fault, but because they put it out there and made it seem as if you had to fight over positions.
Come on.
Y'all won't say
that. No, ma'am. Go ahead. You in all our streets.
You
in
there. Lord, look at somebody and tell them, we're not going to fight each other no more.
We're not fighting each other no more.
No more. Nah, I'm passing this.
We're about to take this to another
level. That's how it's supposed to be.
Yes, ma'am.
Hallelujah, because now we're going to allow the enemy to understand that we're not going to fight each other anymore.
That's good.
Hallelujah. But God began to deal with me about Leah. And he begins to talk to me in the 15th verse. 16th verse. He said, Laban had two daughters. The name of the elder was Leah. And the name of the younger was Rachel. Leah was tender-eyed. But Rachel was beautiful and well-favored. And Jacob loved Rachel and said, I will serve thee 7 years for Rachel, thy younger daughter. And Laban said, it is better that I give her to thee than I should give her to another man. Abide with me. And Jacob served 7 years for Rachel, and they seemed unto him but a few days for the love he had to her. And Jacob said unto Laban, give me my wife, for my days are fulfilled, that I might go into her. And Laban gathered together all the men of the place and made a feast. Isn't this something how they can come together to make a fool out of you?
See? Wow. Oh my God.
Eat and party.
What?
And it came to pass in the evening that he took Leah, his daughter, and brought her to him. And he went into her. And Naaman gave unto his daughter Leah Zilpah, his maid for a handmaid. And it came to pass that in the morning, behold, it was Leah. And he said to Laban, what is this thou hast done unto me? What is this thou hast? Now that messed me up right there.
Okay. Please talk about it.
He was in the dark.
And I'm still not understanding what he means done unto him. Right. Oh, Leah right. is more hurt.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because he don't got some pleasure.
Yeah. Right. No.
Right. Come on, man.
And hello.
But she had to wake up with the mindset that he thought he was making love to me.
Right.
To my sister.
Right.
And he was making love to me.
What? That's good.
Horrible. Yeah.
Horrible. He said, what is this thou hast done unto me? Did I not serve with thee for Leah? Wherefore then hast thou begot?
Jesus.
Laban said, is not be so done in our country to give the younger before the firstborn. Fulfill her week, and we will give thee also this also. And we will give thee this. This.
This.
I want that to sink in. This. Also for the service which thou hast served with me yet 7 other years. And Jacob did so and fulfilled her week, and he gave him Rachel, his daughter, to wife also. And the 30th verse said, he went also unto Rachel, and he loved also Rachel more than Leah. And serve with him yet 7 other years. Father, we thank you for your word. Righteous. In Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
You can have your seat. Let me kind of work with this a little bit, because we as women need to understand that oftentimes our issues with each other did not start between us. A third party is always involved when we start coming in odds with each other.
Yes, yes.
The majority of the time, especially in the body of Christ,
yes, ma'am,
we're fighting each other because we are fighting for the position of getting the attention of some man that we think can make us.
Lord have mercy.
Oh, wow, that's good.
Yes, ma'am. That's good.
And so we have fought each other because we're fighting for positions and territory and love and goodness, and we're fighting for a better life through avenues that are not conducive to where God wants to take us. And so here he is. He has 2 daughters, an elder daughter that's tender-eyed and just not. And it lets you know that there was a distinction between them, because they let you know her eyes was messed up, but Rachel was beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
And so it tells, and the Bible says, and well-favored.
Well,
oh my God.
Favorite.
See, oftentimes we in the body of Christ are fighting among each other because we look at somebody and think that they got more favor than us.
That's good.
And we think that because man is promoting them and opening doors for them more than they are you.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, y'all ain't saying that.
Yes, ma'am.
And we get around each other and we begin to look at each other with contempt.
Jesus.
Because we're looking at the fact that one looks like they're favored and one looks like they got it going on. But you got to understand, Rachel was beautiful, but she was barren.
Yes.
She didn't have nothing in her to be able to produce. She didn't have no fruit in her. She wasn't able to bring anything forth. Oh, y'all ain't saying nothing. Hallelujah. And so they didn't understand that it's not how good you look on the outside.
Amen.
No matter what Jacob thought about it, hallelujah, he couldn't connect with Rachel because he looked at Rachel's outside, but God said his lips inside.
That's good. That's good.
It's going to bring you what you need.
Yes. Come on.
I might not be the one you want, but I'm sure that's the one you need.
That's good. That's good.
Might not be the one the church want to hear, but I'm the one they need to hear.
That's good.
Might not be the one you want to hear, but I'm the one you need to listen to.
That's good. Oops, there it is.
A whole lot of times, people are looking at, and women self-esteem go down, and it shouldn't go down because beauty go only last and get you by for so long.
So long. That's good.
I remember this lady saying something to me, and she, you know, she thought because she was cuter than me.
Oh Lord.
She said something to me, and I said, all you can get is a mattress.
Come on down.
Some of them just say they got your back.
Yeah.
mean that shooting. Come on, Nicholas. And the reason why they won't put you out front is because you don't fit the pattern.
Yeah.
You don't fit the pattern.
Well,
you don't fit the pattern. You gotta have a certain look.
Right. Don't fit it.
You gotta have a certain look in order to be made to feel valuable in the kingdom of God.
Come on here.
He worked 7 years and got something he wasn't expecting.
Wow.
He worked 7 years and then worked 7 more for a woman that couldn't produce him nothing.
My mama. Yeah. Wow. Wow.
That's good.
And what she don't understand, the only reason why her womb was open is when Leah finally said, now. Let me name this baby different.
Jesus.
When the Lord realized that she was no more intimidated.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. By Rachel.
Yeah.
Then it was Leah. Being a woman that understood that she was valuable, that caused God to look at Rachel and finally open her womb.
Yes.
Jesus.
Yes.
Look at somebody and tell them, I thank God for my Leah.
I thank God for my Leah moment.
Yes. When they didn't think I was worth anything in the body of Christ. When they never thought that I would be anything in God's house. When they never thought I would be able to preach, pray, and prophesy. When they never thought your name would become great in all the earth. Hallelujah. God said, I thank God for being a Leah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Because when you looked at me, oh my God, you looked at me with contempt because I wasn't in this beauty.
Right.
And it wasn't just about that. Let me tell you something. When they're looking for women in the body of Christ in this day and hour, they're not looking for a woman that got a mind.
That's good.
What about some money in a body, huh?
They're not looking for a woman that's able to pray them through. Not looking at me strong.
Yes, ma'am. Come on.
They're not looking for someone that can minister to them.
Yes.
See, what Jacob didn't know was Leah had the ability to minister to him. Mm-hmm. All Rachel could do was look good for him.
Jesus. Come on.
What?
But Leah knew how to minister to him.
Trophy wife. Amen.
Oh, y'all looking at me strong. She knew how to minister to him. That's why he didn't recognize that wasn't Rachel.
What?
She ministered well. She ministered well.
He forgot Rachel's body. He forgot her smell. He forgot her voice. He forgot everything about her.
Jesus, that's good. That's good. Yes. By God.
And she knew how to minister to her husband. Oh, God.
That's good.
Gonna help some of you women, man.
Amen.
Tell me a second home Lord. When you learn how to minister.
Amen.
Minister.
Tell me a stay home when you learn how
to. Come on.
Come on.
Yeah, it will.
That's good.
Woo, Lord.
Right there. Leah knew how to minister to Jacob. She knew what to do. She knew how to deal with his mind. And she knew what to do. Because you got to understand, Jacob had a lust problem.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, he had a lust problem. Because any man couldn't recognize a woman he'd been trying to work for 7 years. He didn't even know a smell or nothing else.
See?
Come on. Texture of a hair, nothing. He didn't know nothing.
My God.
He was stuck on stupid over there. But God knows how to take a woman that has been torn by life and situations. And so often we as women, sometimes even in our childhood started off. Because because of that, many times people look at you and they this with this disgust.
Yes, ma'am.
And they look at you and count you out and dismiss you.
Yes, ma'am.
As if you're nothing because of your background.
Jesus.
Look at somebody and tell them, you better watch my background.
Watch my background.
Because it's my background that makes God love me.
Amen. That's good. That's good.
Yes.
That's good.
Yes.
My God.
Hallelujah. Because many times what they don't understand is, hallelujah, just because you can do it better don't mean you are anointed.
Oh, Lord. Stay right there for a minute.
Because we as women, let me just work this right here. We as women, we know how to fake it.
Yes, you better say it.
We know what to do.
Yeah.
We know how to make a crowd be captivated with us.
My God.
Come on.
No anointing at all. But I can preach. I'm talking, ain't really saying nothing, but I know how to stir the crowd.
Yes, 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 yes.
We sit among each other and we are in competition against somebody that don't even equal up to what we got. And just because I got a crowd following me don't mean that God is following me.
Don't mean me. It's good. Right. It don't mean it's good. Right. Yeah. It does not mean that. It does not mean that.
So many times as women, we're fighting each other. And they got pushed into a situation because their father didn't have enough sense to let God be God.
Yeah. That's good.
Yeah. Hallelujah. And sometimes even among the body of Christ, oh, God, I'm going to get into
it. No, you're not. Go ahead, Mother. Go ahead. You're all right.
Sometime among the body of Christ, we are fighting. I know I'm about to get into
it. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Come on.
Loosen it. Let it go.
We're fighting for men sometimes.
Come on.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's good.
I teach a class.
That's good. That's good.
And I always tell the woman when they get married, you'll know if you made a mistake. If you don't increase.
Yes. Increase.
You don't increase.
Work it.
Then you're not with your right spouse. Because when God brought man and woman together, he said be fruitful. Which means we gonna
increase. Yeah, that's right.
We're going to increase. If I diminish,
come on now,
then I'm not with the right one.
Wrong answer.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh. Yeah.
See, Rachel got a sympathy husband. He was with the right one with Leah.
Yes.
Come on.
Because he increased with her.
Yeah. Whole lot. Well,
look at somebody and tell them, but I'm fruitful.
But I'm fruitful.
I might not fit the pattern the church want, but I'm fruitful.
Yeah. Yeah.
I might not be who everybody want for the, oh, but look at somebody and tell them, but I'm producing.
But I'm producing.
Hallelujah. And the problem with the people of God and the problem among the women is they're looking at each other and they're looking at each other through the wrong eye. Right.
That's good. That's good.
Because people are trying to make us begin to fight against each other.
Yeah.
Yes. You're my sister.
Come on.
Jesus.
Come on.
I'm not looking at you with contempt.
Come on.
I'm not looking at you as somebody that I need to fight against.
Come on.
You're my sister.
Come on. Yes.
Which means that we are going to battle together.
Come on. Because
we both don't this
come on.
Together. Because Leah and Rachel never realized what they were thrown into a fight that they shouldn't have never been in.
Thrown in the middle of mess.
Jesus.
That's good.
Jesus.
That's good.
Yes, somebody and tell them, I wasn't supposed to be fighting her.
I
wasn't supposed to be fighting you.
Nope.
I wasn't supposed to be talking about you.
Nope.
I wasn't supposed to be trying to destroy you. I wasn't supposed to try to take you down. I was supposed to be your sister.
She in there.
Yes, she in there.
Look at somebody and tell them, I'm not going to fight you no more.
One flaw. Yes, ma'am.
Because she was everything else.
Yeah, was she?
But she had one flaw.
One flaw.
She was tender.
One thing.
But she was capable of doing anything else.
Right.
Being anything else.
Yeah.
That one flaw they thought stopped her from being favored by God. Oh God. Look at somebody and tell you're looking at me wrong.
You're looking at me wrong.
Look at me and tell me, see me through the eyes of God now.
Jesus.
Look at somebody and tell them, I'm not worried about Rachel.
Word about Rachel.
Rachel need me.
Rachel need me.
That's good. I'm done.
See, everybody want to feel sorry for Leah when they preach this lesson.
Right.
But Leah was the one that was able.
She was
to bring a change into Rachel.
Oh, okay.
Oh, God.
My God.
Look at somebody and tell me, ain't worried about Rachel.
Worry about Rachel.
Look at somebody else and tell me, I ain't worried about Rachel.
I ain't worried about Rachel.
I ain't worried about girlfriend.
Huh?
Who? She's like, who?
See, the one thing about Leah was when she named her son Judah.
Wow.
Oh my God.
And that caused a change.
Shift.
Things begin to shift and things begin to take place.
Yes, ma'am.
And it was so much so to Rachel was mad.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
And she began to tell him, I need some children or else I'm dying.
See.
In other words, you better give me some children or I'm going to commit suicide. Jacob told her, this ain't none of my doing.
Come on, man.
God got your womb closed.
See.
Woo! What see. You need to do was get on your face and pray.
Come on.
Because what he was trying to tell her was, I'm working.
Hey, now. Get with the program.
The Bible says in that 32 said he got mad at Rachel for answering him about them children. He said, am I in God's stead?
What?
Ain't nothing wrong with me, baby.
Leah
can prove that to me. In the body of Christ, but look at somebody and tell them, I am the number one woman.
I am the number one woman.
That's right.
And Rachel was so messed up after he don't told her and got mad at her till she turned around and gave him her maid.
Yes, she did.
Hey, I don't care what she thought, you still wasn't having no children by her.
Right. Exactly.
You don't run around and climb. claim another woman's child, talking about that God has gave, he ain't gave that to
no.
you.
No. No.
You still is in the dark.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Look at somebody and tell God is getting ready to do great things.
Amen.
And it got so rough. To Rachel asked Leah to give her her mandrakes. And she turned around and told Rachel, is it a small matter you gonna took my hood? Now you wanna take my food too.
See?
You don't got my position. Now you want my time.
See?
Wow.
Now you're trying to take my whole ministry.
Lord help us. Lord help.
Wow. Now you're trying to take everything. Come on. But look at somebody and tell them. It's about to turn again.
It's about to turn again.
And she sold her husband.
Yes, she did.
For
yes,
some
she
mandrakes.
Yes, she did.
And then Leah turned around and let Jacob know, I brought you.
Wow.
She met him in the field and told him, I brought you. You try to fool us and make a fool all of us, but we selling you.
What?
What?
Yes.
The player don't got played.
Yeah.
He didn't care because the Bible said he laid with her anyway. Come on. So it didn't matter how it did. That's why I said he had a lust problem. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Because if he loved Rachel like he said, it wouldn't have mattered what happened. Come on, man.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
Come on now. Something was wrong with that picture from the beginning.
Yeah.
You still was going in to live.
A whole lot.
While you were talking about how much you love. Can I help some women that waiting on somebody else's hug?
Cam, you remember this guy right now.
He going to tell you he love you, but he's still working with his wife.
Can I say it?
He gonna tell you.
Uh oh.
You know it's banned in the body of Christ right now because women are sitting around waiting on.
Thank you.
Somebody else will love. Right now. It's a big thing right now. But look at somebody and tell. Look at somebody and tell them don't sell him for no man trade.
Don't sell him.
And it was after Leah had had 8 children.
Yep.
Eight.
Phew.
Jesus.
Seven. She had 6 sons. And then she had a daughter.
Yes, she did. Yes,
yep.
She did.
7. Mm-hmm. God said, okay, now. I have completed this thing. Mm-hmm. And it was after he had completed his assignment with Leah. That he now opens up Rachel's womb. Look at somebody and tell them, don't worry about Rachel.
Don't worry about Rachel.
Because Leah's coming through.
Yes.
Worried about the Rachels in the body of Christ. The pretty girls.
Damn.
But look at somebody and tell them, don't worry about me. I might have a flaw.
I might have a flaw, but I'm proof.
Oh, yeah, I'm producing something in the body of Christ.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. Look at somebody and tell them again, I'm fruitful.
I'm fruitful.
Uh-huh. Yeah, all you flawless ones. Y'all bear.
Oh.
Come on.
How many people on Facebook?
Look at somebody. Look at somebody and tell them, I ain't worried about them flawless ones.
I ain't worried about them flawless ones.
Because it's the ones that got some issues that God is using in
yes.
Come on now. I told somebody up there, so you can't tell me nothing you ain't been through nothing.
Yeah. Jesus, come on.
You don't even know what it means to warfare. Yeah. You can't show me how to fight.
Woo, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
But Leah learned warfare.
Good God Almighty.
Through a man she had got involved with that was none of her concern.
Jesus.
She wasn't thinking about Jacob. Her father envisioned a plan. Because he saw her flaws and he thought she would never amount to anything. She'll never get nothing. She'll never have nothing. Oh God. Hallelujah. He thought about she might have to stay with him.
See how they do.
Put something together to get her out my house. Because the older, the younger ought not be. Oh God.
Come on, man.
Oh God. See, they want the younger women coming up now because they that's what is my thing, do what I want to do with
them. Yeah. Lord,
the older women are more settled. Except for the ones that's in cougaritis. You know
what Cougar.
But they more settled and they more. And I'm looking now, and I'm seeing younger men now reaching out for older women.
Yes.
Because they're tired of the games that Rachel play.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. They're tired of the games Rachel play.
Yeah.
So they're tired of them. So they're looking for a woman that's settled. They're looking for someone. Because you got to understand, Leah had the ability to know how to get Jacob to a position to where he was willing to go into Leah, even though he loved Rachel.
I'm done. I'm done.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm about to work something.
You better work it.
I always tell women that say they stole somebody's husband. I said, he ain't stolen. I said, you got his body, but that wife.
Come on, man.
You got his heart.
That's it. See?
And he'll tell you anything.
Anything.
Get what he wants.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
I
say,
I ain't gonna leave my wife. Stop playing.
But he ain't going nowhere.
No, right.
Because you the plaything. So Rachel didn't understand, hallelujah, that even though she thought Jacob loved her so, she was the plaything. So you gotta watch out because what you deem to be love. It's just a plaything. Look at somebody and tell them, I ain't worried about Rachel. The Bible said he worked those years and still he wasn't satisfied. God, stop letting yourself women be devalued. God has a husband for each of you. Those of you that married, you got your husband. Stop trying to divorce him.
Come on. Boom.
That's the word.
Let me see it, boy.
If y'all increasing,
come on now.
But if you decreasing, because the Bible declares from the beginning, I'll say it again. One thing he gave them was a mandate to increase.
That's right.
They have to multiply. They have to increase. They have to grow.
Yep.
Things got to get bigger. That's things got to get better.
Yeah. Come on now. Yeah.
That's right. Mandate. Yeah. When man and woman come together according to the law, there has to be multiplication.
Yeah.
Husbands and wives, when they come together, oh God. When they come together.
When they come together.
When they're not fighting each other. When they're not coming against each other. when they're not playing games with
right,
each other.
Right, right, right.
They have to come together.
Amen.
Do it like God said, yes.
Come on.
When they come together on one accord,
come on.
One mind, Jesus. In the household.
That's right.
Amen. It's going
to
multiply.
Yes.
There's going to be an increase. Everything's going to increase.
Yes.
Love going to increase.
Yes.
Peace going to increase.
Yes.
Joy going to increase.
Yes.
Your finances going to increase. Increase in every area
yes,
of
ma'am.
Your life.
Yes,
you
ma'am.
Come together
yes.
with the one God has ordained.
Yes,
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 Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes,
yes.
Look at somebody and tell them, don't worry about Rachel.
Right? Don't worry about Rachel.
Because God is getting ready to move for the leaders in this
yeah.
house.
Yeah.
Mm. The women that have been forgotten,
yeah.
pushed in the corner.
In the corner.
My God.
Only
my
you.
God. My God. My
the
God.
Never counted word.
My yeah. God.
To be anything of value in the kingdom of God.
My God.
I'm saying that.
Yeah.
Some of you need to understand, you had to go through what you went through. Because he had to show Rachel that you the one that's favored. See, they looked at it and said she was well favored. But her favor was because of her beauty. Not because of her ability to do anything. It was just because she was beautiful.
Wow.
That's good.
Leah had the ability because the Bible said she was out in the field and everything. Rachel was at the house. Maybe she was going to get Jacob that night.
What?
And then had to turn around, then had to turn around and sell it. So she can get some food. Come on. You got to understand, when the Lord gets ready to do what he wants to do, he'll take the underdog.
Oh, yes, what you say?
Yes,
he will.
Yes,
for underdog. Y'all looking at me strange.
Yes, ma'am.
Y'all look for the one most popular. That's why you can't worry about that. That's why you can't look at them as competition.
Come on, man.
Because that's not how God brings increase.
Amen.
That's not the one. Oh, y'all looking at me strange. And right now, there is a changing going on. There's a reversion taking place in the body of Christ. And many of the women right now are not understanding it. So that's why you can't get caught up. And whether you see people with crowds, stop trying to connect with people because you see them with a crowd. You got to connect to the one that's bringing production.
That's right. Yeah.
Amen.
Sometimes they might not have a crowd, but they produce.
Yeah.
Y'all looking at me strike. They might not have a crowd. Might be on nationwide TV, everything. Y'all looking at me strike. Not according to that. That's a camouflage. For what I am limited in doing. When people have a whole lot of people around them, it's because they are limited in doing
something. Jesus. Wow. That's good. Wow. That's good.
God.
That's good.
Wow.
So I have to bring other people to make themselves look productive.
Right.
Y'all looking at me straight.
That's good.
Y'all looking at me crazy.
That's the truth.
So they bring a lot of people around them because they need, but a person that produces, you don't see them with a whole lot of people.
Can run by myself.
What?
You don't see them with a whole lot of people.
Hey,
a whole lot of this, a whole lot of that. They're able to produce.
Yes, ma'am.
All they need is one. Touch and agree.
Amen. Yeah. Amen.
They ain't looking for no whole bunch of entourage and all that stuff.
Nope.
You don't need no 50 people.
Nope.
Come on. All I need is one person that's going to come in agreement with me.
Amen. Amen.
And I can produce. Come on.
Hallelujah.
Look at somebody and tell them we need production.
We need production.
Hallelujah. We got tired of connecting to barren people.
Oh, Jesus. Wow.
You waiting on something to happen that can't happen. Oh, God.
Dried up.
Oh, God. I'm about to mess up again. Let me tell you women something. Ooh.
Come on. Mess up, Father. Mess
up. What y'all say? Y'all gonna need some men in the midst.
Amen.
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 told him I'll never have a women conference and don't have a man in there.
Absolutely not.
That's why I have somebody that carries seed.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. That's why I invited him in too.
See, y'all have somebody that carries seed.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, that's a law.
Yes, ma'am. That's good. Yes, ma'am. That's good. Yes, ma'am. That's good.
So in order for us to produce, we're going to have men in the midst.
Yes.
For all you man haters. Hate men because you're mad because somebody's going to be, see, if you waited on God, you wouldn't be mad. Yeah.
Well, what?
Sometimes we mad at ourselves and then we take it out on other people.
Right. Yes.
So we made mistakes. Come on.
My Lord.
Huh? Don't y'all sit here. I know I ain't the only one. Because you fell in love before time.
Oh,
y'all don't want to say nothing right there. You fell in love before time. That wasn't the one you're supposed to fall in love with, but because you didn't ask God before you got involved. You just went on.
Well.
Went on into one of them things, you know what I'm saying?
Falling in love.
My mother. Is this because you're beautiful? Right. Looking at how handsome he was. He fell in love, and by that time, you didn't want to hear God when he said that ain't the one.
Right.
Oh, oh, y'all looking at me strong. Don't make me point y'all at me. Look at somebody and tell them I'm not worried about Rachel right now.
I'm not worried about Rachel right now.
Because God is getting ready to bless the Leahs right now.
My God. Yes.
These are women that have had the odds against them because they was not like other women. Don't have the 36, 24, 36.
Oh,
no,
right, right,
right, right.
Brick house
done. The brick house is no more. What you need to understand, regardless of what you have heard, regardless of what you have heard, in this hour, men is looking for more than a pretty face.
Amen.
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 They need a wife,
yes.
Not just a woman.
Amen. Yes. Amen.
Wife.
Amen.
But they're looking for a wife.
Day.
They're looking for a wife. If you're going to be wife, a wife material, then you got to get past all that.
Yes.
What do you have to offer?
Come
see,
on.
We want to ask the man what he bringing to the table.
Yeah.
What you bringing to the house?
What you bringing?
Besides some debt.
Huh?
Yep. Attitude.
Come on now.
Bad spirits.
Yeah. Bad attitude and bad spirits. Good Lord.
What you bring into the house now? And see, women don't want to hear that because we've been through stuff. And if we don't get healed, we're taking all that stuff and we'll take a good man and make him vain.
Right. Let us say it.
Because of our attitude and we
that's good. Yes, ma'am. That's good.
We'll take a good man and make him bad.
Yes.
And then we want to turn around and get mad and say the devil did.
Jesus. Mama.
When you're the one that caused the situation.
Yeah.
Come on now. Yeah. Hallelujah. We got to get healed before we can have a husband.
Right. Jesus. Right. Come on. Right. Come on.
And then some of you married, you need some counseling.
Right. Yeah. Right. Come on. Come on.
Because the man trying to figure out who he married.
Woo!
One day you're saved, the next day you're cussing him out. He don't know who he met.
Come
he thought he
now.
Had a wife and found out he had a witch.
My God.
About to drive the man
crazy
to the grid. He don't know what to do. We as women, we got to get past that. And see, Leah had to recognize the fact that she was more valuable than what they kept on talking to her about. She had one flaw they kept bringing up in her face. Your eyes messed up. Your eyes messed up. But my spirit right.
Yeah.
I got a flaw, but I'm holy.
Yeah.
I got a flaw, but I'm righteous.
Yeah.
with her sister. But look at somebody and tell them we ain't fighting no more.
We ain't fighting no more.
Look at somebody else, tell them we not fighting no more.
We ain't fighting no more.
Look at another sister and tell them we not fighting no more.
We not fighting no more.
So, some of y'all didn't even say nothing.
All right.
Get him up.
I'm talking.
We ain't fighting no more.
You heard him?
I said it 4 times. Once I said it 4 times.
Look at somebody and tell them, I said, we're not fighting no more.
I said, we're not fighting no more.
Hallelujah. I know you're mad at me because I have a few more engagements than you, but
oh,
I'm not fighting no more. Look at somebody and tell them, we're not fighting no more about that.
We're
growing up now. And God is getting ready to expand you. Come on now, you don't have time to be in competition.
That's right.
We need to work together.
That's right. That's right.
Look at somebody and tell me, you need to work with me.
Work with me.
Hallelujah.
Work
stop trying to me. Fight me over nothing. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Come on,
guys. Over nothing.
We fighting over nothing. Stay in your lane. Can't nobody drive your car like you.
Nobody.
I don't care who trying to get behind the wheel. You know your car.
Yes.
Look at somebody and tell them, you can't drive my car.
You can't drive my car.
Hey, sometimes when you get in these cars, the seat automatically goes in memory to who's
right. Yes.
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 Yes. Yes. Look at somebody and tell them, it's trying to let you know you ain't supposed to be in. You ain't supposed to be walking, trying to walk in this territory right now. Lord, you deserve this for me. Lift your hand and say, God, help me not to be a Rachel. I don't just want to be a pretty face.
I don't just want to be a pretty face.
No, I don't just want to be a. I want to be somebody he can use.
Yes!
Come on! Look at somebody and tell them, I'm fruitful!
I'm fruitful!
Oh, God. Hey, look at you, they don't even understand. God just ain't opened your womb yet. But when he see how they hate you, hallelujah. Look at somebody and tell God about the move because I got some haters now. I was saying, when he saw how she was hating, then he began to move for her. Oh, God. Hallelujah. Look at somebody and tell, come on, hate. I need to move for me right now. Why my haters at? Look at somebody and ask them where your haters at. You got to have a meet with our haters. Come on now, because God getting ready to give you a breakthrough such as you ain't never had before. Lift your hand and say, God, I thank you for the increase.
God, I thank you for the increase.
Feel something moving.
Yes. Thank you for the
increase. Hallelujah, Jesus.
You better catch it.
Jesus.
I promise you, women of God, we get ready to see a magnitude of God's glory. Getting ready to come up on the women that, and the Lord told me even as I was coming in, he said, I'm getting ready to move for the women that have been forgotten.
Mm. Woo! My God.
Woo! He said, I'm getting ready to move for the women that have been forgotten, those that have been forgotten and forsaken.
Mm. Wow.
Because we don't look like.
That's good. Hallelujah. That's good.
Thank you, Jesus. Clogged up, messed up.
Jesus.
But you don't understand. He wants me.
Yeah.
God wants me.
Yeah. My God.
Yes. The people might reject you, but God's favor.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. They might push you in the background and push you to the side.
My God.
But God is saying tonight, tell the women, I'm getting ready to remember their woman.
Jesus.
Oh, God. I'm getting ready to cause them to begin to birth and bring forth in this hour. This is the hour of production. If I ever known that we're getting ready to see the power of God in a way that we have never seen before. Because the Lord is getting ready to do some magnificent things.
Yes, he is.
In all the earth. I don't care what is going on in the world. And that's where the people get messed up because they start focusing on the world. But whenever you see a magnitude of sin in the world, you got to know it's going to be a magnitude of glory in the kingdom of God.
All right now.
Hallelujah.
And the glory of the Lord is getting ready to appear on us like never before. So much so to people are not going to even recognize. They ain't going to even understand who you are. Spirit of the Lord been telling me to tell the people. For the last 2 months, he said, tell them I'm going to make all things new.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Bless your name.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Does anybody else in here know that your life is transformed?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Thank God for your transformation.
Thank you, Lord. Glory to God.
Making all things new.
Yes, ma'am.
Because in this hour, he's not going to allow those that have been faithful.
There it is.
The Lord began to tell me, he said, the faithful.
The faithful.
I'm getting ready to be real fruitful.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, Lord. Wow. Look at somebody and tell, faithful and fruitful.
Faithful and fruitful.
It's coming together now.
It's coming together.
I kept feeling the presence of the Lord, and I know when something has hit from heaven,
my God,
and it hits the earth, and the Lord, two things he released, and I thank you that he gave, because I've been asked, I said, what are you releasing? He's releasing to the faithful, so they can be fruitful.
My God.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Yes. Things that you've been waiting on to take place.
Mm-hmm. My God.
Suddenly. You come out and tell spontaneous.
Spontaneous.
Breakthrough.
Breakthrough.
You ain't gonna even pray about this.
Wow.
God just gonna do it.
Yes. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Keep telling the people the month of August has been a month that God has been proving himself.
Yes, he has.
He sure has.
I'm a witness.
When I said doors is opening,
hallelujah.
Miracles are taking place.
Hallelujah.
Blessings
hallelujah.
Are coming to pass.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is aligning our lives.
Yes, ooh, amen. Yes, amen. Yes, amen. Amen. Amen.
Keep telling me. He said, you tell the people. August ain't over yet.
August ain't over yet.
Look at somebody tell me they ain't over.
Yeah,
he still got time to do what he wants to do.
My God.
And we're sending back. And the Spirit of the Lord told me to say this to the people. He said, tell them they waiting on a ship that already happened.
Already happened.
He said, they still talking about it's a ship. He said, they missed
it. Already happened.
This is the time of manifestation.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
The ship don't took place.
Yes,
well,
now. Uh-oh.
Well, now.
Uh-oh.
Well, now. Well, now.
Yes, Lord. The elevation to the place with the positions.
Yes,
yeah. Look at somebody and tell me it already happened.
It already happened.
You sitting up there still praying on something that's already happened. Hallelujah. Why are you just sitting there?
My God.
Yeah, God.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's
the Spirit of the Lord keep telling me to tell the people why they just keep on sinning.
My Lord.
Faith without works is dead.
All day long.
We don't talk, we don't pray, we don't fast, we don't got before the Lord. The Lord don't did it. He said the ship has happened, the thing has taken place. Why aren't you possessing it?
That's good.
Why are you still sitting back talking about you waiting?
That's good.
heart of mine.
Look at somebody and tell them, it's over.
It's over.
We're not supposed to. He said, I'ma cause the fruitfulness now to connect with your faithfulness.
Yes.
And they're gonna begin to see the manifestation of what the Lord has been saying concerning your life.
Oh,
prophecies are being birthed to come forth now.
Hallelujah.
Come on, lift your hands and tell God thank you.
Thank you.
Every word is true.
Hallelujah.
And every word shall come to pass.
Yes, ma'am.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Spirit of the Lord began to tell me, he said, in this hour, logic will talk you out of your blessing.
Oh, wow. That's good. Wow. Lord, that's good.
He said, because what I'm going to do is going to be just like in the days of old. It ain't going to be explained. It's just going to be experienced.
That's good. That's good. That's good.
I'm a witness.
You're going to have to just trust him.
Yeah.
And know that it is something.
Yes. Amen.
Oh, God.
Amen.
Flip your hands and thank God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You ain't going to be able to tell nobody. I can't even tell you how it's going to happen.
My God.
You ain't going to be able to tell them when it happened.
Wow.
It's just going to show up.
Yes.
So I receive to show up.
He began to tell me, he said, tell the people of God, look for angels on the way.
Yes, God.
Yes.
He's setting up. He's setting it up. He's setting it up. He's setting it up. Hallelujah. And we cannot be in a position now to where we don't trust God. Because we're going to miss the move of God. And I heard the Spirit of the Lord saying, he's been saying for about 4 weeks now. He said, tell the people they better learn my language.
Yeah.
How do I talk?
Yeah.
Oh,
that's good. That's good. That's good.
So that means I can't have no doubt in my mouth.
Come on.
That's
good. That's good. My God.
I can't have no doubt, no nothing negative.
Go ahead. Yes, ma'am.
He
that's
said,
good.
Tell the people to learn my language.
Come on. Yes. That's good.
My Lord.
Yes, ma'am. That's good.
My language.
Yes, ma'am.
You got to learn his language. Decree and
declare. Yes. My God.
That's the name of
He
Jesus.
Said, let there be.
Yes. There was.
He said, tell them to learn my language.
That's good.
I didn't have to pray about it. I just spoke it.
Spoke it. Amen. That's good.
Because the relationship.
My God.
With God.
That's good.
Has to be to the point to where he already know what you're going to say. And already have it in existence before you even speak it.
Come on.
God.
Wow. Oh, God.
I stand before King.
See, people don't understand faith. If they understood the faith realm, they would understand that everything that you speak has already been created. It's just waiting on your voice to activate it. See, it's just waiting on your voice. Because he said, he spoke. And it happened.
That's right.
Let there be light.
Yes, ma'am.
And it was.
And it was good, too.
You getting it? Get it.
Yeah.
So speak it. Have not cause you ask nothing.
My God.
Hallelujah.
He said, if you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you can ask what you want. Look at somebody and tell them who you got inside of. Who you got inside of?
Amen. That's
Who's
good.
Inside
that's
of you?
Good. Amen.
If the word is
that's
in
it.
There,
that's right. That's what it says.
Release it.
Yes. That's it. Yes. Yes.
Look at somebody and tell me you gotta release the word.
Yes. Release the word.
Amen. That's good.
Yes, Lord.
That's good.
We're still trying to rationalize.
That's it.
How it's gonna be done?
Come on.
And so we missed the opportunity.
That's it.
In creation.
That's it.
When God has set in motion what he wants to do in alignment with his will concerning your life.
Amen.
We missed the moment because we try to rationalize and think things out. And if he says speak, you try to figure out, well, how are you going to do it? And he said, hold on, pass. Because it's right at that very moment when it's positioned to happen. That's why when you have faith, you can't wait. You can't doubt. You can't wait. You can't have unbelief. And you don't need nobody with you.
Come on. Come on.
Lord have mercy.
Amen.
That's good. That's so good.
Never have someone with you that don't believe like you do.
Come on now.
Yes, yes,
yes.
Amen. That's good.
Amen.
That's good.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
That's good.
Never.
That's good.
You know the Lord is getting ready to shift your connection.
My God. Jesus.
Boom, give it. Give it by the Spirit. He's getting ready to shift your connection.
Jesus,
he has to, because the vision he gave you is bigger than the minds around you.
Oh, Lord. What?
And so they can't comprehend because they can't see what you see. Wow. So in order for it to come to pass, he got to connect you with people that see what you see.
Yes.
My God.
And the Spirit of the Lord said, your midwife is a killer.
Ooh.
Oh, Lord.
Is it my Bible?
Jesus.
And so he said, there are things that should have came to pass in your life, in your ministry, but you put the wrong people in position to help you. And so those things have been stagnated. For vision should have been so much farther than what it is right now. The work you're supposed to be doing supersedes the people that surround you. And because of that, they can't understand the magnitude of where God's getting ready to take you.
My God.
And even though you've been trying to explain to them that God has transitioned you into deeper realms and deeper places, they can't see it because they, you know what, you in the palace and they still loading on God. So God said, I got to get some people to you that's going to help you really work the vision.
Amen.
You should be woman of God. You should be in about 3 more different countries.
Come on.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. You get that word. Yep.
The Lord said, because of the people. And sometimes you have lagged behind trying to wait on them to catch up. And you have put your own self in a stagnant place. But the Spirit of the Lord said to tell you, he's getting ready to uncoil the snakes from around your ministry. I'm looking at some snakes coming uncoiled. I'm looking at them in the spirit realm. And the Spirit of the Lord said that he's uncoiling those that have tried to squeeze your ministry to them.
Jesus!
People know where the Lord wants to take you, but they don't want to help you get there.
Come on,
Jesus.
My Lord.
And there are even people that the Lord has spoken to bless you, but they withheld their hand because they didn't want you to get there before they.
Right. Ah. Right.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. So the Lord said, now he's getting ready to open your eyes and your understanding to know who really for you and who against you. Your enemies are getting ready to be revealed. Mm. And even before the night is over with, you're going to know.
Mm.
It's three of them right now
that
you absolutely know is against you. But you trying to trying to hope. Because you compare. Can I tell you what the Lord told me?
Yes.
He told me my compassion was going to kill me. You got to let them go. And I know they've been with you. But you need some new blood. Because they have became too familiar with your
My God, that familiar spirit.
To respect who you are.
Yep.
So the Lord said, when they can't respect you, and when they lose honor for you, and they looking at you as they buddy, and they old girlfriend, you know what I'm saying? And not as their leader, as the one that God has given the vision to, and in fact, you know, they trying to change the vision, and everything, and they trying to tell you, you need to go this way, and the Lord done already spoke to you and told you what to do. Now, you can't deviate from the plan. And if you got to lose them, you just got to lose them. Either they're going to shut up and get in line, or they're going to have to get moved.
Come on,
because the Lord says your hour has come. He wanted to push you so far. 5 years ago, you had a golden but you didn't do it because of the people. But the Lord said he's going to give you another chance.
Amen.
Step out in faith.
Thank you.
And do what he told you to do.
Amen.
He should tell you to go get your new territory.
Go, my God.
Amen.
It's waiting on you.
Yeah.
And the people are waiting on you too.
My God.
You got a voice that needs to be heard.
Yeah. Yes, she does.
I have tried to put a gag order on your voice. But the Spirit of the Lord said to tell you tonight, he's bringing you from among the bondage so that he can do what he needs to do through your life. You should have been so far. But he said 5 years ago, he gave you an opportunity and you didn't take it. But he said, tell him, I'm going to bring it around.
All right, ma'am.
Thank you. So I love y'all, but y'all don't want to move.
Yeah.
So I'm going to leave somebody here to help y'all. And I'm going to the promised land. And the Lord said, go to the promised land. You hear me?
Yes.
Go to the promised land. He gave you the state. He gave you. He told you where to go. Now hear the Spirit of the Lord say, even in Abosha, even there are some countries that he told you to go plant. If you have held on to a people. But I heard the Lord say, now set the house in order and be about your father's business.
Yeah. Amen. Absolutely. Amen.
He's pulling us into our destiny. We're going into our purpose right now. And see, if you're not able to go with the chains, you're not going to be able to be used in this hour. Because the Lord is requiring strict obedience.
Amen.
Very strict obedience.
Yes, ma'am.
Lift your hands and say, God, help me not to miss you.
God, help me not to miss you.
Don't you miss him? You hear me? He got some great words. Your quiet storm, the Lord is going to stir up that fire. You hear me? And then I hear the Spirit of the Lord say, I'm going to bless her.
You have just finished listening to the media ministry of Apostle Barbara R. Thomas. You may write her at Apostle Barbara R. Thomas, P.O. Box 13291, Durham, North Carolina 27709. Thank you for supporting the ministry.